特殊部隊リーサルウェポンということなんでしょうか。吉野原に行ったか、吉野原に行ったか。
伊塚さん、野上は放送席です。
伊塚さん、待ってください、待ってください。
Hello and welcome to the third episode of The Best Match Ever. I am your host, Derek Stone, and I am being joined by three of the brightest minds in professional wrestling. And I have a quick question. Hank Huckabee, who is the greatest karate man of pro wrestling?
It's not even a question. Steve Blackman.
I think that's pretty good. He had the like nunchucks and... I think he did a couple of high kicks, and that's a solid answer, I guess. Owen Johnson.
I would say that it's Steve Blackman or Aerostar, because he rescued his friend Drago with glow-in-the-dark nunchucks, and that is better than regular nunchucks.
Okay, so we got two nunchucks. Lastly, Chris Blasco. Who is the best karate man in pro wrestling?
Unfortunately, it's probably Loki. Even though he sucks as a person and is unprofessional, he has really good wrestling matches. He does cool kicks and cool moves that I assume are from karate.
All right, let's see. Nobody went with Glacier, huh? I'm thinking either Glacier or probably the karate master, Billy Graham. Is the correct answer. So everybody got it wrong on that one.
Counterpoint, Eric Bischoff.
Eric Bischoff's a good one. He did come out in a karate gi, didn't he? Okay. All right. I guess I'll buy it. So anyway, to transition from that, our goal is to rank every single pro wrestling match of all time to ultimately find the best match ever. And it kind of seems like everywhere you go online, people always say that New Japan Pro Wrestling is the place to go if you want to truly see the best matches ever. So I thought this week we'd check them out. And since they have so many great matches, I kind of feel like we could almost just pick one at random and throw it on the list and see where it sticks. So I sent out Chris to find a match and share it with us. So Chris, what do you have for us?
Yeah, so this week we're going to talk about a match from New Japan Pro Wrestling, Invasion Attack 2014. It is Daniel and Jolez Gracie versus Takashi Iizuka and Toru Yano in a tag team match. So going over these participants real quick, let's talk about Takashi Iizuka. He's a long-time New Japan Pro Wrestling veteran. He debuted in 1986. He is kind of, at this point in his tenure, he is doing this gimmick where he's out of his mind and kind of goes berserk in his entrance. He kind of goes after fans. He has this thing we'll talk about later where he goes after one of the announcers. And he just kind of generally acts like a madman. Toru Yano, also a veteran, not as much as Iizuka. He debuted in 2002. He is kind of a comedy wrestler. His deal is that he cheats to win. He'll... unbuckle the turnbuckle pads to throw people into the steel. He'll low blow profusely in matches. He's basically like
He's the master thief.
They're the actual wrestler. Yano and Iizuka are the actual wrestlers in this match. On the other side, you have Daniel and Jolez Gracie. They are not experienced pro wrestlers. At this point, this is their, let's see, one, two, three, about their third or fourth pro wrestling match as a team. Daniel Gracie is a Brazilian jiu-jitsu black belt and MMA fighter. He's the cousin of Henzo Gracie. He fought for Pride in the early 2000s, and he ended up with a pretty good 3-1 record, 3-1 record. One of his notable wins in Japan was defeating Shinsuke Nakamura in an MMA fight at the 2002 Inoki Bomai show by Armbar. That kind of formed the basis of his return to New Japan Pro Wrestling and feuding with Shinsuke Nakamura. And
so on the surface level, it may seem weird that these two karate men are in New Japan, but when you start looking at their MMA records and their grappling records and their links to Nakamura and Sakuraba, who are both in the company at this time, it checks out.
So, Toru Yano and Takashi Iizuka come out. They're, like I mentioned earlier, Iizuka goes after Shinpei Nogami, the announcer. In the process, he's pushing away a fan looking for a high five, which is kind of funny. But he attacks Nogami, and he rips off his shirt, and he handcuffs him. And then I think what he did was he spray painted like a bra onto him.
That's what it looks like.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was just it was just some weird humiliation type thing. I thought it was pretty dumb, but I just felt bad because the poor guy had to announce the rest of the night like that, like with his shirt off.
This takes like a minute and a half, and it like there's definitely a point where you're just like, okay, this is going on probably longer than it should. Also, like, it's just weird that Iizuka is supposed to be this like wild beast of a man that carries around a metal claw, but he's taking the time to like very like, I need to make sure I get this bra strap just right. Oh, can you turn around so I can make sure the, the sides connect? And okay.
Yeah, so they are in the ring. Daniel and Holez come out. They're wearing jujitsu gis with their black belts. They're both big guys. They definitely don't look out of place inside of a pro wrestling ring. They look like cool pro wrestlers wearing cool jujitsu gis.
I don't know, man. Holez comes out in flip-flops.
Did he? I didn't notice that.
Yeah, I don't know why I noticed that, but I don't think you can look hard coming. I mean, they don't look like anything coming into the ring, but they could not seem more bored walking out to the ring.
So Yano and Iizuka attack the Gracies at the bell. The Gracies have no idea how to sell. It's immediately apparent that they don't know what they're doing. So they just kind of awkwardly try to throw clinch strikes, and they try to grapple with Yano and Iizuka. Meanwhile, Yano throws Holez outside. He throws him into the crowd.
Yeah, I wrote down, this sequence only lasts about 15 seconds, but it feels like it lasts about 15 minutes.
ホーレスグレイシーが体幹したことのない攻撃殺法かもしれません。まずはホーレスグレイシーが矢野の傷地攻撃、さらには椅子というところか。ホーレスが、しかしバックを取って、その椅子攻撃を回避しようとしています。お客さんの中に倒していきます。そして野上さん、場内ではですね、飯塚が
I never got the sense that Holez is trying to make Yano look bad or like he thinks he's above all this. I think he literally just has no idea what he's doing.
Daniel and Iizuka are brawling in the crowd as well. Daniel picks up Iizuka and he walks him over to the ringside mats, and he's like means to do a slam to slam him down onto the mat, but he does it very, very gently, and it comes up looking very bad. So then Daniel does some basic offense. He picks him up to throw some clinch knees before Iizuka rams him back into the barricade, ends up handcuffing Daniel to the barricade. So back in the ring, Iizuka and Yano are beating down Holez, who's now on his own because Daniel is handcuffed.
At some point, he was, you know, trying to get away from the rails and couldn't. So at some point, he just grabbed a shoe and he just launched it into the ring.
Oh, I thought that was a water bottle.
Yeah.
Was it a water bottle? Because I know nobody was wearing shoes, right? None of the Gracies. So I guess it might have been a water bottle.
I mean, I think it would be way better if he threw in a flip-flop because that could actually strike the fear into me, but not a water bottle.
Yeah.
Yano has a chair. Yano is taunting Daniel, and Daniel tries throwing a kick at him, which is too far away to hit him. It looks kind of funny. And then Daniel tries to choke Yano, and Yano throws a chair at his arm. And I couldn't tell if it missed or it hit. If it hit, it would have been pretty painful, but if it missed, it would have been nothing.
It looked like it maybe hit the barricade, but didn't hit his arm. But I couldn't tell because the Gracies don't know how to sell or anything, so.
Right, the fact that this is like the first time he's sold at all in this match makes you go, oh, is he actually hurt? But no, he's actually just starting to do his job.
At this point, Holez does what I think is probably the highlight of his pro wrestling career. He, Yano goes to choke Holez with his black belt, but he counters it into a flying armbar. And it looked really good. I thought, like I said, I thought this was probably the best thing I've seen in this match.
Yeah, that wasn't bad.
Yeah, one of the positive things I will say about the Gracie's pro wrestling careers is that whenever it was time for them to get just like a little bit of offense in, they looked pretty good at doing it, as long as it was a Brazilian jiu-jitsu type takedown. Like anytime they did a judo throw or anything like that, it might as well be like a replacement for like a suplex in a normal pro wrestling match. So right. Whenever they were tasked to do that, it was okay.
At this point, Daniel is ready to get back to tag in with Jolez, but Jolez has already fought off Yano and Iizuka, so he just kind of like walks over to the side, the wrong side of the ring that Daniel is at. He's basically parallel to where Yano is, so they're both on the same side instead of the opposite where they're supposed to be to tag in and out. And he just kind of does a lazy tag. So basically the spot that was set up was supposed to be that Daniel would be able to run in, get the hot tag, and take over the match. But it didn't work at all. And as a result, there was no heat and no drama or tension at all.
Yeah, the Japanese crowd, who's very polite probably 99% of the time, saw that they tagged in on the wrong corner. And they just, at this point of the match, they just gave up and they just booed this hot tag.
ダニエルが解放された。ダニエルの怒りをぶつけてほしい。ホーレスがダニエルにタッチを行います。
ちょっとコーナーを。
はい。あ、ニュートルコーナーですかね。
Daniel slams Iizuka again. It's the same slam he did before on the outside, where he just kind of lifted him up on his shoulder and slammed him down to the mat. This time it looked better. Again, I mean, he was inside the ring, so he probably had a little bit more confidence in slamming him down and not hurting him. So he passes into full mount, and he secures a nice armbar. Yano breaks that up. And this is pretty funny. Yano knocks Jolez off the apron. He goes to attack Daniel, but Jolez gets right back up on the apron. Like, he didn't sell it at all.
Stay down.
Yeah, exactly. He hopped right back up. So Yano had to run over there and knock him off again. And from here, we go into the finishing sequence of the match. He takes him down with a leg scissors and applies a heel hook, and he gets the tap. Iizuka taps out to that. Match is about 10 minutes long, I'd say. At that point, the Gracies are celebrating, and they go out to the outside. They high-five Nogami, having avenged his earlier assault by Iizuka. And that's pretty much the end of the match. It was not very heated by the end. The crowd was kind of quiet.
They seemed happy that it was over.
Yeah. I think we can all come together and safely agree that this match was terrible.
Yes.
Yeah, it was bad.
Can we all agree on that?
I mean, yeah.
It was on the borderline of so bad it was good.
Something I didn't realize going into this is how much I enjoy watching Yano perform. Like, obviously Yano's hilarious, but he's just an expert at what he does, and he's always in there and he plays his character perfectly. He never breaks character. And I feel like there's multiple points in this match where you can just see Yano is just fed up, which is not a natural look for him. There's obviously the chair portion outside where nothing was working.
Well, like, we haven't talked about it much here, but as all of you know, I am one of the biggest Toru Yano fans out there. I think he is terrific. He's one of my favorite wrestlers right now. And this was the first match of his I haven't enjoyed. And that just made me sad. And you should never be sad when watching a Yano match. You should always be laughing, smiling, having a good time. Because Yano is so good at what he does. And the Gracies failed to do that, and I will always be upset at them.
Well, on that note, let's go ahead and pull up the ranking list that we have now. We currently have number 1, Atsushi Onita versus Hayabusa, and number 2, Hornswoggle versus El Torito. Let's see. Do we want to start at the top or the bottom?
The bottom.
I think the bottom is a pretty safe bet.
This is at the bottom.
All right. We are all in agreement that it is not the best match ever, I believe.
It is not better than our exploding bomb, steel cage, barbed wire, death bomb cage
match.
Match. Bomb match.
Okay. Is it better than the WLC match?
No.
Is there an argument to be made?
No.
The commentary was better in this match, probably.
That's true.
That doesn't matter.
I'll agree. There was no offensive midget humor. There was very offensive, like, rape humor.
Yes.
At the beginning of the match.
I understand, so, you know, Japan and Western audiences, there are cultural differences. This still seemed very wrong.
I think Daniel Gracie is a better wrestler than Hornswoggle.
Come on now.
That's too far. That's too far.
Can Daniel Gracie kick himself in the head?
No, absolutely not.
Is this one of our new metrics for best match ever? Can wrestler A kick himself in the head?
Is his kick better than Hayabusa's kick, or can he kick himself in the head? That's the metric that I'm looking at right now.
How many ninjas were in this match?
None.
Zero.
No ninjas.
Though Toru Yano in a ninja outfit would be very funny.
Yes.
But are we saying number three? Are we saying the worst match ever so far in our list for the Gracies versus Toru Yano and Iizuka?
I don't want to say that this is the worst match ever, but I think it's going to be a while before we find something take the bottom spot on our list.
Yes, I agree.
Yeah, this is definitely the worst.
Now, before we put it on the list, I feel bad. Like, yep. These Gracies did come out, and they did participate. I would like everyone to say one nice thing about this match.
Yano throwing that chair at Daniel Gracie when he was handcuffed looked cool.
I liked Hollis's flying armbar. I liked Daniel's leg scissors takedown into heel hook. Those both look really cool.
Rollis's selling of the steel chair shots made me chuckle a lot, and I will never forget it.
Yeah. And I liked the headbutts in the corner for some reason.
There we go. It's good to pay respect to the Gracies.
It's good to pay respect to this match before we bury it at the bottom of our list.
We will mark it number three, Gracies versus Toru Yano and Iizuka. Maybe we should stay away from New Japan for a little while. It doesn't seem like their matches are automatic wins.
No, yeah, like if this is representative of like their matches overall, I don't think we need to review any more New Japan matches for a while.
Yeah, let's do that. Anyways, thank you everybody for joining us today as this is another episode of the Best Match Ever. Hopefully next time we'll get a little bit better match going, but until then, thanks for joining.